wet, 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 ooh, wet, 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 ooh, wet, 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 ooh, ooh, wet, sweat, sweat, sweat.
Welcome everyone to game two of this exciting NBA playoff series. Kevin Harlan here with Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg, and our sideline reporter is David Aldridge. We'll see the Indiana Pacers and the Toronto Raptors.
Here we go.
Look at Toronto. Well, they came out and did what they had to do in game one. Now, guys, a game two showdown presents the chance to win the series on the road.
And, you know, anytime you have a chance to get another playoff win, you have got to be focused on that game. You know, each game is an entity in and of itself. Yes, momentum is important, but you got to be ready to take care of your business in each game. So the focus has to be right here, in right now.
You look at the Raptors. At this point, Greg, they've got a pretty good idea of what they need to do to win this series.
And in round one, coaching becomes a huge factor. You've seen what you're up against. Now it becomes a question of who can make better adjustments on the fly.
Hey, there are guys who have played as long as LeBron, okay? But how many have maintained their physical abilities the way he has so late in his career? I think that's a short list.
Now here's LeBron. Nice move. And there's the drive. That one goes in.
Hard to play better defense than that, guys. I mean, but right there, James simply overpowered him.
A little over a minute gone here in the first quarter. Pass to LeVert. Just five on the clock. Indiana needs to get a shot off. It's going to be a 24-second shot clock violation. They turn it over.
Toronto ball.
Enzo Ayton will bring it up for Toronto. James outside. Oh, good with the triple.
You know what, though? Sometimes you can be too open. I think it may have surprised him, and that's why he missed.
When a guy has a 7'6" wingspan like Porzingis does, it's just tough to get away from him or get by him. It allows him to block a lot of shots.
And here's Toronto. Now it's ended down to David Aldridge, who was able to talk with Rick Carlisle.
Thanks, Kevin. We talked about the difficulty of slowing down this dynamite offense.
All right, David, sounds like they're very concerned about preventing an early run by their opponent.
No doubt. You don't want to play catch-up if you can avoid it. They're going to lean on their defense to try to keep this game in check.
Yeah, and, you know, it's a tall task. Great offense tends, in most cases, to beat great defenses. They've got their work cut out for them.
Now here's James. Driving to the basket.
Still possessing incredible athleticism. LeBron James, when he attacks like this, you can almost forget about stopping.
Here's Wall. That one's in. His first bucket of the game. He's one for two.
And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
Well, this early, they should be showing a lot more energy on defense. Not there.
And we've seen him do that before. Batter a defense by just exploding to the basket.
Mr. Porzingis. Back to KD. That's his second shot and his second basket. He's two for two.
What a unique combination of height, athleticism, and ball skill. Durant can make some unbelievable finishes because of it. Tell you what, just add that one to the highlight reel. James is truly one of the greatest slam dunkers of all time.
Here is Durant. After Toronto picking up the basket just moments ago. Here's Wall. And the call on the shot sends him to the line.
Wall figures out ways to draw fouls and turn those into points. He is a dynamic point guard.
And now we'll get perspective here on how the hustle game has been going for Toronto.
Boy, they've really amped up the pressure at the defensive end, guys, and have piled up the steals in the early going.
Yeah, and one thing, Clark, I've noticed is how quick their hands have been tonight. Thanks to that, they've gotten a lot of points off of turnover.
You know, going back to John Wall's college career when he was at Kentucky, he may have only played one season, but he racked up some pretty nice awards. All-American, Conference Player of the Year, just to name a couple. And I tell you, he packed a lot into just one season.
Out to the right wing. Simons from outside. And the rebound goes to the Pacers. Here's Wall. LeVert with a wide open look. That three off the mark. And Simons, he's got the ball here for the Raptors. They trail by one. It's LeBron with the drive. And Kings throws it down.
And LeBron is a force rolling to the rim. When he's diving inside, he's looking for the punch.
Here's Wall. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. That's on LeBron James.
Second team.
The Pacers shooting their third and fourth free throw attempts of the game. First one falls for them. So both teams making some changes here. And that's good as he hits both of his shots. And the Raptors with the ball. Outside, Simmons. To the middle. And Aldridge slams it in.
Really rare to see a guy that's 6'11 have the kind of elite passing skills that Ben Simmons has. Really, really impressive.
Now, here's Wall. Here's Nance. Side Porzingis. Gallinari with the steal. Banked in off the glass.
Well, that's why they're in front. Aggressive play at both ends. Nicely done.
Here's Thompson. Here's Nance. Simmons pulls it in. Toronto leading by three. Driving the lane. Simmons on the wing. To the paint. And Aldridge slams it in.
Well, he's so good around the basket that he doesn't really need to throw it down. But sometimes Aldridge just has to take advantage of it.
Yeah, there it is again. On a lot of their possessions this first half, they've established a great inside position.
And this is his first trip to the line tonight. And it's the Raptors' ball. Simmons inside the line. And Simmons slams it in.
What energetic drive that time by Simmons. Pushes right through the defense and gets it to go.
They get it back. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws.
And with the offense getting right to the rim, at least they save the layup.
Old school D right there. Just telling him no easy layups. It's as simple as that. And that's what you expect from them. Making it look effortless. Send this guy to the stripe, he's going to cash in more than not.
To the inside. Aldridge. And Thompson sends it back. The drive by Nance. It's sent back down by Simmons. Going inside. No one near Rozier as he lets it fly. Good on the triple.
Got to defend this. I mean, Rozier is more than willing to take the three ball if you give it to him.
Nance outside. 8 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. And it's sent back by Aldridge. And so it looks like the Pacers will retain possession here.
First substitution. Jaren Jackson Jr.
Here's Thompson. And he converts the layup. Thompson's got five now.
There he is.
And they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing the ball into the paint.
Here's Simmons. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
Sometimes you just have no way of stopping Simmons on the interior. I mean, he's a very skilled player who gets these calls routinely.
Oh, we've seen some great shots in the first quarter. No shortage of offense. It's the Raptors leading by four. We'll get right back to the action when we return.
Ladies and gentlemen, your North Side Crew.
And glad to have you with us as we get going here in game two. And from what we've seen so far from the Raptors, guys, your thoughts?
I mean, offensively, I thought they did a good job of protecting the ball. And defensively, boy, were they disruptive.
Yeah, I like the way they forced a ton of turnovers and then took advantage of those turnovers with opportunistic baskets.
Puts the D in a tough spot when you have a point guard who can throw it down.
He really does, G.A. He really does put pressure on you.
And you know, guys, showing how dynamic a weapon he is for this offense, they feed off of that energy and ability to make plays. It gets them going.
Second chance shot. Here's Quickly.
An elite defensive threat and presence. Simmons understands exactly how to use his body to position himself for excellent defense.
Back to Simmons. Walker in the corner. From the arc. The basket good off the assist from Simmons. And the Raptors lead by nine.
And creating a little separation here, gaining some confidence.
Yeah, you get the sense that they're going to start stretching this lead out a little bit.
And that assist got him a little nod from his teammate after that one.
Here's Simmons, following the basket by John Wall. Oh, and the jam by Ben Simmons.
You know, whenever Simmons gets a chance to show off his insane bounce, he takes advantage of it, really demonstrating how lethal he is in the air.
Thompson misses.
Man, I can't believe he blew that gimme, guys. Well, I know he's frustrated about that.
Really no idea why you're fouling in a situation like that. You know, maybe there's some bad blood between those two.
Yeah, but that's no excuse for that kind of foul. I mean, that might be an explanation for it, but certainly doesn't justify it. And even then, it's just not a good play.
Toronto working the ball around now. And it's out of bounds. They say it was last touched by Jackson.
Raptor ball.
Second quarter of basketball, just over a minute and a half played. Here's Simmons. Here he goes. Here's Aldridge. Outside, Simmons. And then Simmons slams it in.
The slashability of Simmons. Really creating havoc for the defense with his aggressive cutting mentality.
Who wants a free feature? Time to make some noise.
Pacers trailed by 11. It's offline from half court.
A shot like that is a polite way to say, hey, coach, bench me.
Hey, that's crazy there. I mean, insanity. At least wait until you get across half court. My goodness.
Oh, a nice defensive play to disrupt the alley-oop.
Well, that's not been a typical possession for them in this first half. You know, for the most part, they've been pretty smart with the ball.
That's a double whammy, guys.
That's right. A great defensive play, then the emphatic stuff.
Well, turning defense to offense, we talk about it all the time. Try to hit your opponent at the other end before they can set up the defense.
John Wall.
And the slam dunk by Wall.
really like Wall's attitude on offense in this game. He's doing everything he can to create points.
Pass to Rozier. Simmons on the wing. Six to shoot. Porzingis with the steal. And an intentional foul right there.
Ben Simmons. That's his second personal foul. First team foul. Substitution for your Raptors.
And so it's Porzingis. He'll bring it up for the Indiana Pacers. 9-point game. Pass to LeVert. Durant wide open. He fires. That's good. And it's LeVert with the assist. Durant's got 7 points. Now Ayton. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
Jackson Jr.
And you see the raw talent Ayton has. An intimidating big man with a high ceiling and a desire to grow.
Off on that one, so he goes 1 for 2 at the line. Pacers trail by 7. A try, KD. LeVert in the corner. Down low. Tried to shoot. The 3-ball. And the Pacers, another 3.
3 points.
Durant's shot is in the air before the defense even tracks the pass. I mean, he's 2 steps ahead of him. And that, folks, is a combination of awareness and speed.
And it's sent back by KD. 3-pointer, Simon. Hands it from downtown. And the Raptors lead by 7. Durant feeling it out a bit. And he drives in. Tries again. Toronto grabs the miss. They've led by as many as 11 points. James. And James throws it down.
Yeah, they call him the freight train. But for Han James, when he's coming down the court like that, good luck trying to stop him.
Pacers trailed by 9.
Emmanuel quickly.
Pass to Korkmaz. Off target from outside. Here's Toronto now. Inside. And slam dunk by Harris.
You know, I think the passing skills of LeBron are his greatest asset. And he's got some great ones in addition to that. But his passing is otherworldly. When you get open, he gets it to you with exactly the right speed and pace so you can handle it.
Strong move to the 10, trying to get guys going.
Hard not to get motivated, GA, right when your teammate makes that kind of play.
You know, when you're looking to close the gap, you need guys who will take it upon themselves to step up, take the initiative, and make something happen.
Wow, and that sort of showmanship is just deflating right now to a team trying to get back into a game like this.
Ouch, Greg, that is definitely an emphasis jam. A big apostrophe or exclamation point, maybe even a question.
And guys, I know there are a lot of questions right now defensively for this team. There's no doubt about that.
Pastor quickly. To the middle. They double him with LeBron. And that one is good.
Nice recognition there by Porzingis. He's getting better and better as a passer.
This will be his 3rd free throw shot of the game.
At the line for the Pacers. Emmanuel quickly. One shot.
And the free throw, no good. Raptors leading by 9. Westbrook wide open. He fires. Drains the 3-pointer. Westbrook's got his 1st bucket of the game, and he's on the board for 3. He takes it in, and that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
That's his 1st.
He's shooting free throws, number 4 and 5 here. And quickly drops them both. 107 left in the first half. Porzingis with the block. And he gets it back. Pass to Ayton. Six on the shot clock. The try by James. And finished off by LeBron.
This game, another feather in LeBron's cap. And by now, he's got a lot of feathers in a lot of caps. What a night.
Toronto foul.
I mean, even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
No question about it. I mean, a ton of contact and a good call by the official.
Shooting for Indiana. Chris asks, Porzingis.
And both free throws good for Porzingis.
Well, he's certainly been on target with the free throws. Such an advantage when you're big and knock them down from the line.
An absolute beast inside. Love how Ayton uses his size to draw these fouls.
He'll take his third and fourth free throw shots of the game right here.
Wow, what, did he have something in his eye on that shot?
Pacers trailed by 10. To the paint. It's tipped. It's stolen by Harris. LeBron with it. Picked up by Thompson. LeBron drives in. And then jammed down as he goes right over Larry Nance Jr.
You know, once LeBron's at the rim, you might as well turn your head if you don't want to appear on a poster somewhere. Because he's throwing it down with force when he gets to the rack.
Hands in the high post. Here's Quickley. He can't get it to go. Drives to the hoop. And that concludes the first half. Raptors lead by 12. Well, it doesn't get much better than playoff basketball. Let's get back to the action here in round one. And here's James. He'll bring it up for the Raptors. The 12-point lead, the biggest of the game. And the dunk by LeBron.
Beautiful reverse jam right there.
Use the rim to protect the ball, I think.
Outstanding awareness and a terrific finish.
Here's Wall. It's tipped. Here's KD. And KD throws it down.
Well, the elevation from Durant should come as no surprise there. I mean, he's dangerous above the rim, and he can go way above it too, folks.
Now, here's James. He's got 21. Three-pointer, Simon. Porzingis with the ball. Westbrook picks him up. And the slam dunk by Wall.
Wall showing us a little spurt ability in his game. That's the way to reward your teammates for an outstanding defensive play. Way to go, John.
Here's LeBron. Back to Ayton. And Ayton throws it down.
Oh, I love watching him flush it home. Showing how easily he can get off the ground and bang it.
On the wing, Harris. Pass to Ayton. Kicks it out to James. Crafty move. Here's Simons. Yes, that's LeBron picking up the assist. Simons has got his second basket of the night. Sweet move. Here's Jackson. And he battles for the ball and gets the second chance bucket.
And I like seeing Jackson use that length on the offensive glass. You don't have to be the most physical guy when you have a wingspan like that.
Now here is Harris. Gets the three-pointer to fall. Harris has got five.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific ball move.
Really a prime example of the difference in how these teams have operated offensively. Much more individual play at the other end.
LaMarcus Aldridge.
Pacers trailed by 16. Outside, Wall. And the foul is called. He intentionally grabbed him there for some reason. I don't know.
Kevin, all I can think of of it is that he's trying to slow the game down a little bit. Right. That's a stretch, though. Definitely a strange move on his part.
And stolen by Simmons. Walker with a clean look. Offline with his three. LeVert with it. Now guarded by Simmons. And it's LeVert missing. Raptors leading by 16. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up.
Simmons doing a nice job being visible, taking the foul, and still getting the shot up.
He shot two free throws in the game, made one and missed one. He hits the second from the line. Pacers trailed by 17. Wall looking for an opening. A strong finish under heavy pressure all over. He's got 17.
Well, you certainly can't fault him as the reason they're behind. He's been on target and on top of his game.
And that's an intentional foul. Here's Aldridge. Here's Simmons. Shot clock at 6. And another one in the scoring column for him. He's 7 of 10 from the field.
You know, what touch from the Australian native Ben Simmons. I mean, so good at staying under control, even when facing physical contact.
That should give him a nice little jolt.
Yeah, it has to. They need a jolt here.
And you know, that's exactly what happens when you don't settle. That's the result. Tremendous effort and a big-time finish there.
Driving in. And the rejection by Jackson. Here's Wall. And Wall with the slam.
This is John Wall at his absolute best. In attack mode. Going right to the rack.
Out of bounds. Indiana takes possession.
Indiana ball.
The Pacers making a change here.
Substitution.
So, timeout called here. The first for Toronto.
It'll be a Raptors timeout.
All right. Look who's coming on the court. Come on and get loud for your Northside crew.
So here is Indiana, down by 15. Here's Durant, and it's sent back by Aldridge.
You know, over time, Aldridge has really developed into a pretty good shot blocker.
And it's Durant with the ball. He'll bring it up for Indiana. Here's Jackson. The shot misses. Here's Steve from Aldridge.
Good offense squaring up against better D there. Got to appreciate that stop.
Pacers trail by 15. Pass to Jackson. Aldridge with some nice D. They've shared the load offensively.
And guys, they put the defense on their heels. You can see right now, they're trying to react. And that's what you want when you're in a rhythm offensively.
Here's KD.
The shooting numbers just aren't there yet in the fourth.
Simmons with the defensive effort. And here's Walker outside. The basket good off the assist from Simmons. Walker's got 6.
You know, pretty much anybody can hit that shot when they're that wide open. I mean, terrible defense.
An offensive mastery right there. I mean, great move in the lane and then the flush.
But just no way for the D to handle it.
Well, I tell you what, you just got to sit back and admire the creativity there.
Clearly a foul.
Yeah, he took a shot there, earned those free throws.
He hits both from the stripe.
You know, Ben Simmons has shouldered a lot of criticisms about his game, but You know, I love the fact that he keeps his head down and just works hard and continues to mature as an outstanding all-around player.
It's sent back down by Simmons.
What do you guys think so far about the offensive approach for Toronto?
Guys, the passing we've seen from them has been tremendous. Very unselfish.
Yeah, but also give them credit for the layups they've had tonight after a strong drive to the basket.
And both free throws good for Rozier.
You know, Rozier is known as an energy guy, but he's also a talented scorer who has a real hunger to continue to improve.
Kept alive. Jackson.
Jaren Jackson Jr.
Lays it up off the glass. Jackson's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Jaren Jackson Jr.
Second chance points always hurt. Just not enough effort to block out.
Hey, guys standing around spectating. Man, you got to get in there and get tough.
He's off on the second.
And he's made more of an effort here to put pressure on the defense in the second half and create some contact and free throw opportunities.
That's a textbook example of how to move the ball. Boy, you gotta love that action.
Toronto ball.
And so it looks like the Raptors will retain possession here. Simmons on the wing.
Indiana foul.
1 point in the game.
Emmanuel.
And the call will be against Emmanuel quickly. So that will be his second foul of the game. We're in the bonus. We'll go to the line to shoot two.
And Simmons.
Good on the second free throw. Pacers trail by 18. On the wing, Melton. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line. This is his first chance at the line tonight.
Second team foul.
And he knocks down the first one.
Shooting for Indiana.
Melton hits them both. There's 49 seconds left to play in the third. Simmons feeling it out a bit. Over to the left wing. Aldridge, no luck. Pass to Jackson. And the layup's good off the glass. And that's now 6 points for Jaren Jackson.
They are just killing them on the interior.
Yeah, you can't say that with enough emphasis. I mean, the defenders are just not being aggressive enough down low. You got to play with some physicality in the paint.
From 11 feet away. And here's Nance. With one on the clock. And the dunk by Jackson.
And the flush from Jackson Jr. Great wingspan, and at 6'11", he's got a little nasty in him.
And so it's Ben Simmons making highlights for the Toronto Raptors. And of everything he's...
Come on, fans! It's the fourth
NBA playoff, round one. Thanks for joining us as we get back to the action on the court. And so it's Wall. He brings it up for Indiana. A 12-point game. To the inside. Back to Porzingis. There's LeVert. And that one is good with the extra effort on the glass. LeVert got the fourth quarter going with the first basket of the period here for Indiana. From 11 feet away.
Simon.
A shot's good from Simon.
Boy, still such an outstanding distributor. James takes great joy in finding his teammates in their spots.
Pass to Melton. Porzingis at the elbow. A fadeaway. Count the basket.
You know, Porzingis' ability to shoot the ball well from every level really opens up the floor for him and his teammates. He'll make that mid-range, Jay, as much as he makes threes.
Pacers trail by 10. Into the lane. Melton.
Toronto foul.
shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws. That one on Ayton.
Shooting for Indiana.
First free throw is good. The Pacers making a switch here. Melton hits them both.
And even though they're down, they are putting on a show at the free throw line.
Yeah, they're making the most of their opportunities.
Oh. And this sort of awesome dunk is one of the reasons this team is in charge of this game.
Well, there's a swagger out there. You can see it on the court that they possess and are not afraid to show it either.
Boy, and I used to love going up and jamming it down like that, guys.
Nance with it. He's picked up by James. Back to Wall. Indiana moving the ball. It's good. That takes him to 77% shooting this game. 10 for 13.
Wall is so strong, he's able to brush off contact and still find ways to creatively score.
Unloads from 13. Rozier for three. It's good from long range.
Not shy from outside. There's no doubt about that. Spreading the floor and getting them up.
Love the mentality there, I tell you. I know I've never coached, but, man, playing to win and being aggressive even with the lead as opposed to being safe and going into prevent offense, I'll take the former all day long. Play to win.
That's his second first. Second team foul.
Just over 2.5 minutes played now here in the final quarter of regulation.
Since halftime, he has just been in a funk offensively. They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
And when you make five in a row in close like that, it also takes pressure off your perimeter guys, too.
Down low. And stolen by LeBron. And the basket by Rozier. Rozier's got 5 points now this quarter.
Well, you've got to be careful around LeBron and mindful of his presence now. He's very opportunistic defensively with that size, speed, and anticipation. He can pick your pocket.
We've got an update here, so let's catch up with David Alderton.
Hey, Kevin, I heard Rick Carlisle during that last break talking with the team. And he was emphatic. He said, we are not going to win this game playing this way, fellas. You've got to step it up. You've got to get aggressive. And you've got to battle to get back in this thing. See if that pep talk got him going, guys.
Thank you, David. From 17 feet out. Shot clock at
David
5.
Thompson.
Count that one.
And all those second chance points have given them a boost here in the second half. And that's a great way to cut into the lead.
Pass to LeBron. We've played just over 3.5 minutes now in the fourth quarter.
And that's his fourth, and no doubt he would have liked to have not gotten it this soon.
Free throw good, LeBron.
Pacers foul.
Both free throws good from James. Pacers trailed by 11. To the paint. Here's Melton, and it's Ayton with the rebound. They go to the intentional foul.
Anthony Melton. That's his first personal foul. Second team foul.
Now LeBron. Fires top of the key. Good, he hits the jump shot. James has got 25 points in the game.
That defense has to worry so much about LeBron as a passer that it opens things up for his jump shot.
That free throw good from Porzingis.
Shooting for Indiana.
That's also good, so he hits both free throws.
What impresses me most about Porzingis is how versatile he is. I love that about a big man who does a little bit of everything.
And now they decide to foul intentional.
13 down.
LeBron outside. The kick out to Rozier. Drills the three-pointer. Rozier's got 10 points in just the second half.
and perimeter scoring, I have to imagine it was a topic of discussion at halftime.
Certainly. I mean, they saw a weakness in the perimeter defense and took advantage of it.
Gets a finger on it, but just can't quite come up with the steal.
Clearly a careless pass. He got away with one there.
Kicks it out to James. Wall gets a hand on it.
Well, there's not much John Wall can't do defensively when he's focused, because he's really athletic and fast.
If they want to, they can milk the clock just a little bit here.
Yeah, that's the best option.
Back to LeBron. Pass to Rozier. From deep. Good, and the assist goes to James. And the Raptors lead by 17.
Well, and this has been their strategy throughout the fourth period. We'll see how it pans out.
You know what? Teams can get a little three happy down the stretch sometimes, letting it fly.
The real. Come at us, and we're coming right back at you.
A little back and forth from long range. I love it. That's a terrific answer there.
On the wing, Melton. And here's KD for three. And again, it's the Pacers from deep.
If Durant can find just a slice of an opening at the arc, he'll take it. His accuracy is just that good.
And he can time his passes so perfectly. Now, what an assist.
Ladies and gentlemen, your North Side Crew. Substituting for the Pacers, Caris LeVert, Jaren Jackson Jr.
Here's Melton. Goes up and lays it, makes it easy. Melton's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Boy, Caris LeVert has done a nice job elevating his playmaking ability, which helps him and his team.
Raptors leading by 11. Here's Simons. 1:16 left to play in the final quarter. It's stolen by Wall.
And how about the stingy defense there to deny that pass?
Now let me remind you, John Wall has been an all-defensive player in the NBA. When engaged, he can lock down and lock you up.
Now here's LeBron. Driving inside. And James throws it down.
And guys, that's going to wrap it up. Fans are piling out the exits. Obviously a huge win here in game two for Toronto.
They enjoyed a big boost from the strong play of their bench.
The subs came in and did their job. Those points off the bench were key to their victory.
And you know, when you look at the huge impact he had, just a for LeBron.
Boy, he was absolutely relentless at the offensive end, guys. Smelled blood and went for it.
Caris LeVert. That's his first personal foul. $15.
First free throw is good, and that reversed the lead to double digits.
Taking two shots.
And a tough break as his second attempt at the line, no good.
And that should be enough to get the job done, even though he didn't get all of them.
Would have been impossible for KD to miss his teammate there. He was wide open.
Here's Toronto. They led the game at 1 point by 20. Rebounded by Jackson.
You know, you'd love to see him pull that off, but instead he goes from highlight reel to the bloopers.
Durant for three. It's money from deep.
And all of a sudden, that three puts them in striking distance, guys. He's had that shot working all night.
You bet he has. Working overtime. The triple's been his bread and butter in this ball game. Nothing but butter. Sweet butter. And
give them a clue, bare feet in the street, no it isn't the shoes. Try stop me, they lock me, I found them keys and drop freeze. I'm just a young man, keep trying to search like I'm jump man. I don't really care about who it is, they wanna see me, not shooting it. Black Panther and low sway pubis, see me on the court like okay boomers. I keep singing,
I can't find a line.
So I keep looking, so I keep looking. We keep singing,
I can't find a line.
end. Click. Let them run up there and have the hand. Holes in the game with the ball and sin. They feel the mood in the street.
Yes, yes.
They see they move on the speak.
Okay.
They seen what I do with my peak.
Yes, yes.
Dream team, I do to my sleep. Whoa. Back to reality, back to the ball. Mamba mentality. If you need me to score, just give me the ball. What I do when I call belongs in the gallery. Yo, miss a shot, you don't take. Yo, be the boss, you don't wait. We beat the yard. 80,000 years beyond the paint.
I keep singing.
I can't find a light.
So I keep looking.
Looking.
So I keep looking.
Looking.
We keep singing. Keep singing.
Y'all miss shots you don't take. Y'all miss shots you don't take. Y'all miss shots you don't take.
So let me shoot that.
I've been doing that. You've been doing this. We've been doing it tough. That's love.
That's what?
That's love.
That's what?
My place. My home. My veins. Ice cold.
I've been doing that. You've been doing this. We've been doing it tough.
My place, my home, my veins. Ice cold. I've been doing what I want. They've been doing what they told. Push it.
Now keep singing. Doing it tough, that's love.
That's love. That's love.
That's love.
That's love.
That's love.
That's love.
That's love.
That's love.
That's love.
That's love.
I've been doing that. We've been doing this. We've been doing it tough.
Hey, yo. Atomic. Been taking three flavors now. And yo, Whitney got the Whitney hit behind the Warhol, dipped the Bergdorf. And yo, seven in the back learning lessons. Getting dry and it be ready in a second. 40 chains on Halo, I'm a god. Fear of God, jogging, rocking. I don't even jog, hanging out the wagon, sunroof. Meal with the chill bezel. All my phones ready, make me feel special. I'm looking real, and yeah. Keys and money, green Teslas. Told Virgil right on my, on my, right. Told Virgil right. Hey yo, a Mary's filled in the fashion district. Hey yo, Norman. Try to test me, now to miss it. Milk quarters, still awesome. Water, still forcing. Out the faucet. Tell Virgil right. And yeah.
Lil Brody let off. He ain't even flinch. Dip to the A, nobody seen him since. 560 bins and I ain't need the tents. My weak ascent cost more than your mama need for rent. That's just for one. Leave you. For a week and it's gonna leave a stench. Rappers coming to my city, they gon' need consent.
Need,
cause we already know you, we convinced. I told Virgil right, the nicest with ain't right this, I just spit.
And yo,
on my, this ice drip on my fist, no shoe deal, but look at all this Nike that I get.
Yeah.
On Doe Street, this that I pitch, 2 in the morning on the corner, night shift with my, no. I'm rich, put all this off-white on my.
Yeah.
So if it's, we ain't even asking. We just pulling up and somebody gon' see it.
Hey, yo.
Ash and Benny like James Worthy, Kareem and Magic.
Yeah.
Every time Griselda drop,
yo,
gon' be a class.
And OK's the, yeah, cocky. Finish Versace with the stone-faced Medusa, Sopranos, and Maggiano's. We got gold-plated.
Ah.
Your whole frame to.
And yeah.
Got all eyes on us, can we chill? Eating with snakes, probably getting. Trust me, A family had a Henry Hill.
What up?
And every man don't got a Benny skill.
Nah.
When you this dope, it take at least 50 mil just to sit me still.
Like 10 on my lip.
To my right wrist when I. Runway Margiela, that type on my. Butterflies and spikes, that type on my kicks. These rappers wanna be trendy, they wanna be friendly, but never. She wear Forever 21 like it's Fendi. I told that it's Givenchy, she pronounced it Givenchy. She wanna me and run through all my accounts till they empty. What would do. I'm still thinking militant. Oh, laying around, I got rid of it. I settled all my differences. I really had it. Like I stepped on it with a Timberland. The butcher.
Going to change people. It's something that no one will ever be able to capture on film. It'll just be something that you see, and all of a sudden you realize, I'm on the wrong page. or I'm on the right page, but I'm on the wrong note. And I've got to get in sync with everyone else to understand what's happening in this country.
Keep running all night. Passenger side, Bonnie and Clyde. We're alive, we'll be.